with that, I'd like to turn it over to Clyde. We'll kind of walk you through some of the design aspects of the vehicle. Thank you.
Thanks, John. Good morning. Can everybody hear me over the fountains back there? Not so much? Maybe even louder?
Yeah.
Is that better? Need a bullhorn. Hi, my name is Clyde Ney. I'm from the design office, and we're introducing today the final piece of the new Jeep puzzle of our new lineup. It's sort of the middle slot in our seven slot grill in our new seven vehicle lineup. One of the things that we have the opportunity to do now that we have an expanded lineup is to basically redefine what this vehicle was. The first time around, the Liberty had to sort of do double duty. It had to sort of be the entry-level mainstream vehicle in our lineup, but it also sort of had to fill the role of the four-door Wrangler, which we didn't have at the time. There was a lot of people who really wanted that feeling of the adventure of the Wrangler, but they needed the utility of the four-door vehicle for their families. So now that we have a broader lineup, the entry-level vehicle has basically been taken over by, you see in the background here, the Compass has now become sort of the entry-level, sort of what was the Liberty Sport. The Patriot is sort of the Renegade. And the four-door Wrangler has now become a real vehicle. So now that we sort of know what we were going to do with the vehicle in its lineup, we had to discover what part of the family it was going to be. As you've probably heard over the past couple of years, we've sort of branched the Jeep lineup into two vehicles. We have, or two sets of vehicles. We have the modern side, which is represented by the Grand Cherokee, the Compass, and it's sort of where the former Liberty used to live. Then with the Patriot, the Wranglers, and the Commander, we had sort of the classic side of the family. We didn't have to debate this very long because we've received lots of people over the course of the year, Camp Jeeps and other events that really loved the Liberty, but they sort of missed the styling, that traditional styling that sort of had always drawn them into the Jeep lineup. A lot of these were the former Cherokee owners and people who've had Jeeps in the past who really love the image of their vehicle, and Jeep vehicle buyers are very, very passionate about what they own. So what we decided to do was sort of make a sort of modern interpretation of that type of vehicle, but holding a few of the cues that we had from the Liberty. Part of it was we had the stand-up sort of nacelles that you see sort of on the modern side here with the lamps that sort of bulged up through. This time we sort of simplified it a little bit. We sort of just have a slight little kick up in the grill, what we sort of call the shield, okay? Jeeps, if you look at the traditional side of the family, the classic side, they've always had that shield, which is always a big part of the Wranglers and the CJs from way back when. It's sort of part of our face. The seven-slot grill is not just all of it. It's that as well. We've also sort of picked up a little bit of modernness with the way we handled the headlights this time. We sort of integrated them more into the design, the way we did with the Commander. Except this time, instead of dual elements, we have a big single element. We moved the fog lights up behind the lens. Sort of made a little sophisticated touch to it, but still sort of that classic face. And also, one of the things that we sort of went back and forth on was the hood. A lot of people like that Renegade hood that we did, more of the Wrangler type, where it was flat, more traditional, more Jeep in some people's minds. So that was definitely had to be part of it, with the power bulge on the top. So I don't have to keep yelling here. I'd like to get all you people out here. We'll stand around the vehicles and I'll sort of talk about the rest of it. You sort of make your way back here.
Pretty big space.
Yeah, lots of room.
Okay.
can get back up this way. Alright. Is it everybody? One of the things you're going to notice about the Cherokee, or the Liberty, forget, Cherokee in Europe, is the fact that now the sport model has color-keyed fascias and flares. This is sort of something that we noticed. We did a lot of spring specials over the years. We discovered that this buyer, this segment of the buyer, really sort of likes the upscale image that the color-keyed flares gives you. We also didn't really need so much of that Jeep Wrangler image that we had, which is now being taken care of by the four-door Wrangler. So we're able to move it a little upscale. But one of the questions we've asked at Camp Jeeps, do we still need to have the plastic removable flares? And a lot of them said, yes, you gotta have those, because when I'm off-roading and I'm doing some serious off-roading, sometimes they get banged up. And they want to be able to replace a nice, easy plastic flare without having to redo their whole fender and repainting the car and all that. So it makes that type of lifestyle a little easier. The way we differentiated it this time, since we're not doing the flares, is on the sport model, we have a color-keyed grille. We have black accents, sort of a nice traditional, sort of functional look. And the limited model behind us here, and I know we got kind of a heavy crowd, but we have lots of chrome accents, trying to bring the vehicle a little more upscale. We did that last time, but it works really well with the new vehicle, with the rich grille, the large wheels, and the light bar on the rear. What I'd like to do now is point out the fact that you're sort of all spread out, but we have a 2-inch longer wheelbase. One of the great things about that is it makes the rear seat ingress egress a whole lot easier. If anybody's trying to jump over the wheel well in the last vehicle, we'll really appreciate that. We also have more legroom in the vehicle, which is really gearing it more for a family sort of lifestyle now. The overall length of the vehicle is 3.3 inches longer than the old one. And that's not just the body. That, if you count the spare tire that used to hang off the back of the vehicle as part of that overall length, we're three beyond that. So one of the things you'll find, and I'll walk you all back to the rear of the vehicle now. Is that with the spare tire underneath the vehicle, we got a lot more floor space in here for the stuff that people haul around every day, groceries and whatnot. There's a lot more floor space to hold your goodies. Another thing, we have a feature that we had on the Grand Cherokee, which was really liked by a lot of Jeep buyers. It's a feature that fits the Jeep lifestyle. There's some hidden storage under here, sort of a blow molded plastic tray. Allows all sorts of long-term weekend items to be sort of hidden under the floor. We also have the reversible tray, which we had from the Grand Cherokee as well. Again, because it went over so well with the lifestyle of the typical Jeep buyer, where they'll have a lot of dirty stuff to put in the back here, muddy boots or fish or whatever else they put in the back here. One of our young designers, he made a comment that he has a couple young kids, and he said this is a perfect changing table for his babies. and why not? You know, you can take the thing out, you can hose it off, you can flip it back over nice and clean and put it back into your vehicle. One of the things you'll notice now is also on the passenger side here, we have a subwoofer and we have tweeters on the rear door. We have this premium sound system, which is absolutely terrific. You just get a chance to crank the stereo up today. It's pretty nice. We have the jack on the opposite side. Before, the jack was under the seat. Now it's a nice handy spot. I'll also point out that on the sport model, where you don't get the subwoofer, you get an extra bin in that side for more storage. Another thing you might notice is we have two locations for the cargo shade. The reason for that is because we now have a reclining rear seat, which just makes the rear seat that much more comfortable. People like to have their storage, their stuff in the back there hidden really well, especially during the holidays and stuff where they have a lot of valuables underneath there. And so what we tried to do is we have two positions, one for when the seat is full up and the other for when it's in the recline position, so that you basically have that cargo shade, the seat back coverage. Another thing you'll notice is not only do we have a full flat floor, and it is a really flat floor now, there's no angles, no nothing, really makes good use of the space, but we also have a full flat front seat that really is terrific for putting long items in the vehicle. Now, some of you may ask why we don't have the sort of pull-out floor that they have in the Nitro. That's sort of a different type of buyer. That's a person who likes for their weekend shopping and stuff like that. There's a sort of utility for that, that the Jeep buyer wants something different. He wants something for a little more long-term over the weekend, something he can carry his ropes or whatever else that he has underneath there, and it just sort of makes everything all nice and neat and clean in the back there and keeps it hidden. All right, so the next thing I'll do is I'll sort of walk you around to the side. Can you all see decent enough? You might want to open the lift gate back up again if that's the only way you can see. One of the things that we really had to concentrate on this time is we had really good fit and finish with the last Jeep interior. We had really good quality with the interior. We didn't have any complaints. But we did have some complaints with a few of the way we handled some things. One is people just didn't like the light switches on their console. They thought that was a little bit of an odd location, just wasn't what they were used to. So we put them back on the door where they should have been all along. We realized that. We also were sort of always being asked, you know, if there's any way we can get any more storage space in this vehicle. We have much larger door pockets this time. We have little cubbies in both the knee blocker and the center stack. Little storage trinket trays in the console. Two big cup holders with a Red Bull sort of can holder in the middle here, which is also good for like McDonald's small coffee without it spilling around when you're out there jostling around. But one of the best things we've managed to do is to get a much larger center console. And how we were able to do that is by going to an electronic transfer case switch, which allowed us to take the parking brake and move it farther forward, which allowed us to move the armrest forward, which in turn gave us a much larger console bin for storage. As far as styling goes, one of the things we tried to do is make it look a little more upscale, a little more rich. You'll see there's a high contrast two-tone in both a gray color and a tan family. We have two-tone steering wheels. We have lots of silver accents and chrome accents on the limited model. We have a little less of that on the sport model, but overall it's a much more upscale feeling vehicle than in the past. And one of the things I'd like you guys to do when you all get a chance to drive this thing today is to just try to live in the vehicle the way you would in your own vehicle. You know, unload your pockets if you do that. I know I do. Just take the phone out and put everything where it's nice and handy and see if you can find a place for everything, because that's really what it's meant for, is to live with the person. Okay?